Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I know I have been absent because residency has just been like, you know, like residency step three is like, you know, I'm just like, can I just have like 2 seconds to myself, please? Please. Literally, I've been residency. We had orientation in June. And it's because my birthday was September 15th and today is September like the 18th. I think it's September 18th. I don't know what day it is, but I know it's not my birthday. So literally this is the first time that I've done anything since residency has started. Literally all I've been doing is going to the hospital, coming home, study, sleep. Go to the hospital, go to the clinic, home, study, sleep. Like, that's all I've been doing. So sorry for the delay, but I just wanted to make a quick video of what do you do after you hit that submit button on your ERAS application. So you guys, I know, calm down. It's okay. You've made this far for a reason. It's gonna be fine. So after you hit submit on in September, on the 29th, I believe that's when all of the programs can see your application. And so they get, say for instance, they get like 5,000 applications. They channel those filters and then those 5,000 become like maybe 800 or 500 or 1,000. And then from those, that's when they all sit and, well, some of them will all sit and just go by one about the application, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Do we want to waitlist this applicant? Do we just send them a rejection letter or do we want to invite them for an interview? So usually how that happens is like maybe around like 2 weeks, you will start receiving interviews. But with that's kind of like a toss up because different programs do theirs differently, right? So it's not an all fits all. Shoe fit to one all. I don't know. You know what I'm trying to say? Not every program does the same thing. Some program will filter one time. They will send all their interviews at one time and that's it. Some programs will filter. They'll look at a set like, hey, for the month of November or for this week of November, we have 30 slots of interviews. We're going to send out 30 slots for that. And then maybe around a week or two later, we'll start going through it again and see if we're gonna comb through some more and then send the interview or put a wait list. Or some programs don't even have a wait list. You either get an interview or you don't get an interview. So how last year's worked was because of COVID and everything, our match cycle was really fast. Like soon as I hit submit, like the next day I was getting secondary applications. And so basically what secondary applications is they'll ask you like additional questions, like why do you want to come to this program, or tell me a little bit about yourself. That's like another way to filter people out. So say for instance, you apply to somewhere in Alaska and you don't want to go to, and you say, I don't really want to go to Alaska, I'm just applying. You don't do the secondary application. That's how people filter you out. So if you get a secondary application and you want to go, first of all, don't apply places if you don't want to go to them. But if you apply just willy-nilly and you get a secondary application, do the secondary application because that's how they filter out people. Because sometimes it requires a lot of work. Like some of people, they have like an interview. It's like a thing online where it's like a personality quiz and it's like how you interview, what would you do in different scenarios, and that can take up to like a couple of hours. And that's a secondary application. And based off those answers, if they think that they like your answers, they think how you would react to certain situations, they'll send you an interview after you spent 2 to 4 hours on doing just a supplementary application. Or they'll send you additional, like, hey, answer these questions. You have like a week to answer these questions. If you don't answer it, then that's that. So you have that. You also have That's like the main two secondary applications. Some programs, like I said before, they send all of their interviews at the same time, some of them. But anyways, so after you receive that secondary application, you submit it and you're playing the waiting game. Like, the waiting game, honestly, I just kept myself busy because when you're waiting, you get really anxious. You're like, why I didn't get an interview, or why are people getting interviews? That's another thing. Do not tell people, do not let people, like, unless you're like really close to them and you really want to share. But when someone gets an interview and you don't get an interview, it causes a lot of anxiety because you're like, well, why did they get an interview and why didn't get an interview? Or why are people getting interviews and I'm not getting an interview? Just zip it, zip it, zip it, zip it, zip it. if you don't want the extra anxiety, just keep it to yourself. It saves you a lot of drama and, like, well, not drama, but just unnecessary stress. Because just because that person got an interview now doesn't mean that you won't get one later, or it doesn't mean anything. So, because you don't know what that program is thinking, you're not in the program director's head of the reason why they chose this person over you or anything of that nature, you don't know. So it's better to just stay to yourself and just go through the motion. If you want to share it, then fine. I only shared with, like, my very, like, very, 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 very close friends. But other than that, like, I didn't really share, and I didn't want to, and I didn't ask people how they were doing, because when you are sitting by your phone on the computer and you're not receiving invites, and then someone else asks you, hey, did you receive an invite? That just adds to stress. So don't harass people and ask them, like, did they receive interviews? Because they probably don't want to talk about it right now, because that's a lot of pressure. Match is a big deal, and that's basically the one of the last steps in your profession in medical school, career to start your profession. So that added stress of people asking you, like, hey, did you get interviewed? Did you get interviewed? Did you get interviewed? Like, really, just leave people alone. Leave people alone. So speaking of that, so the way that the interviews go is they will send out either invitations via their emails. So check your spam folder, because it may go in spam. You also want to check ERAS. ERAS will send it, or they send through a thing called Thalamus. And Thalamus is like their own, like, interview service, things of that nature. So what I did was I put ERAS application, ERAS service as a VIP. If you have an iPhone, I'm not sure if Android does it, but if you have an iPhone, you can put things as like a VIP. So anytime I got a email from ERAS, it popped up like a text message immediately. Because the thing with things being online, when you're not having to travel and spend 1 to 2 days traveling, going to interview, versus me sitting in front of my computer for 4 to 8 hours doing an interview, people in their own home, you're not traveling, you're not spending extra money, you're not spending hotel money, you're not spending a lot of money. So what do you think people are doing? They're going to accept basically all the interviews that they're going to get. There's not going to be that many people, like, withdrawing or saying, hey, I can't make it to this interview, because the cost is lower. The amount of time that it takes to interview is also lower. So you have more people, like, who are getting interviews and then just keeping them. They're not going to give their, 9 times out of 10, they're not going to give them up, because people, one, are nervous that they're not going to match. Two, the convenience of having online interviews and you not actually having to spend the night before the interview day. Usually there's a dinner. So that's one day. Travel, get there, hotel. Then the second day is interview, and then you walk around the campus, meet everyone, see how everything's doing, and then you leave. So that's 2 days versus 4 to 8 hours on your computer. You could take a half day off of work, or if you're a student, take a half day and still go back and see your patients. That's what I did when I had interviews. So the convenience of it makes it easier for people to quote unquote hoard interviews. I know there was like this thing on Reddit. Stay off Reddit. Stay off Reddit. Don't do what I did. I was on Reddit. There's like this thing where people's like, oh, I have these amount of interviews. Because people lie on there, okay. But there has been, I know people who know people that was hoarding interviews, had like 30 or 40 interviews. So people hoard them. So you have to be like very on it when it comes to notifications. So I had ERAS notifications on VIP. And if I didn't receive an email, I checked my email every hour on the hour. Okay. Every hour on the hour. Just because as soon as you get an interview, you want to try to schedule it as soon as possible, because some programs, they will send out interview slots and then don't have, they'll say, hey, we want you to come to your interview, and then their interview slots are full. And then you have to wait till they add dates and then you can, or they may only have one date left and they send you and there's only like two spots. So you have to be very on it when it comes to that. So some of the things is, the overview is, once you send out your application, the programs will put in their filters, whatever that is, and then they'll come down to a small number from like 6,000 to like 500, and then they will comb through some more of the applications, and then after that, they will pick who they're gonna interview. And sometimes that's sent all at one time, or sometimes they will stagger it and they'll send a half back to their interviews in the first, then another half, and in the middle of the match cycle. So if you could do it that way. The other thing is, you want to be on your phone. Like, do not play when it comes to those interviews. So you want to put, if you have an iPhone, put those notifications on VIP, so it pops up anytime you get an ERAS notification invite, pops up, and you're able to schedule. Have your laptop on you at all times, because sometimes, like for example, I was rounding and presenting, and while we were walking down the stairs, I got an email that said, "Hey, I could you come and interview?" I said, "Excuse me, Dr. So-and-so, I just got an interview invite. Can I please just take 2 to 3 minutes just to run downstairs to get my computer so I can get it?" They were understanding. Like, just like, okay, just go ahead and go and then meet us back. So I always had my phone on me and I always had a laptop on me, because you want to be on top of it, especially with the convenience of it all, with everything being online. So keep your phone on VIP. If you can, keep an iPad or a laptop on you or in your backpack near you, just in case like the internet on your phone's not working, or sometimes the browsers for the interviewing, whatever interview service that they use doesn't work. So you want to always have a backup plan. So with that being said, woosah, it's going to be fine. And if you feel like you want to share your journey with other people, or you want to stay to yourself until the end of it, it's whatever floats your boat. Me, myself, I only share it with like very few people, because when people get interviews, you'll be like, dang, why didn't get an interview? Why did I get interviews and I'm not getting interviews? So stay off Reddit, stay off Student Doctor, and stay off all this stuff, because it's just going to add more anxiety. Like, yes, I was on Reddit, I was on Student Doctor, and I was looking at stuff, seeing who got interviews and stuff. It just adds a whole nother layer of anxiety, and it's just not worth it, honestly. So the best thing for you to do is to believe in yourself, woosah, that everything will work out, and just see where the dominoes will fall. Because at the end of the day, what is meant for you will be for you, and your journey is your journey. So you can do not compare yourself to other people. So I will be back later on with another video when interview season is starting. So I hope that video was helpful for you, and I wish you all the best. Hopefully better than my singing, but I'll see you guys later. Bye. Bye.